Hey YouTube, this is Gary from the Thomann Brass Department. Today we're going to take a quick peek at some student level trumpets. You don't have to spend a lot of money to get a really nice horn that'll do the job. Starting off, we have the Jupiter 700R model. This horn, like all these horns here, is a medium large bore horn. This one in particular gives it a really nice feeling of being very stable, very well built. Valves work fine, it has a nice core to the sound, and the notes slot really well. So you can't really go wrong. Let me just play some few notes here. The transition between the notes is really, really defined. It doesn't have, there's not a whole lot of sloppiness or slurring. Yeah, can't go wrong. Has a traditional thumb saddle. We'll turn it around this way. An adjustable finger ring. It's pretty standard. Starting out, you may have small hands. 10 years later, you may have big hands. And this just lets you tune the notes that need to be tuned down low in a comfortable way. So, that's that for the Jupiter. Next up, we have the Yamaha 3335. This is kind of an oddball. It's in between the 2 series and the 4 series, and it doesn't get a whole lot of attention, but I think it deserves more attention. Very solidly built. This is Yamaha quality. Don't laugh, but if you're not happy with a Zeno, give this one a try. This one is a player. You'll notice here, the tuning slide, normally they have either an inner tube or an outer tube on top, and this one is just kind of cut right in the middle, and that's to facilitate a more optimal brace position. It's a little bit more forward, it'll project more, you may not get as much feedback, but it's a really nice mix. Again, it has a much more, if you see the Jupiter thumb saddle, it's noticeably bigger. It gives your hand a little bit more freedom. The Yamaha thumb saddle really snugs your thumb. If you like that feel, this horn's for you, maybe. Again, the valves are fine. You're not going to have any problems with Yamaha valves. Some of the best in the business. The sound is a little bit brighter than the Jupiter, but it's not bright. This is something that should work in pretty much every situation. That's fun. You don't have to pay a lot for fun. Just gotta buy Yamaha, maybe. Now we have the Bach TR-501. Bachs just look different, they feel different. It's no wonder that so many people are hardline Bach fans. A little bit better braced, you can see here, right here on the main tuning slide. You have 2 main braces here. this gives, this actually isn't just optic, it gives some stability to the sound. Again, you have kind of a, actually this is really flat, I was going to say D-shape, this is more of a, maybe referred to as a square tuning slide. This is really flat here. This gives a little bit more resistance, give more security when you play. I do think, although this one has a very stable, very Bach traditional sound, the intonation on the Yamaha would be slightly better. But then again, you're gonna play this with your mouthpiece, not my mouthpiece. And you'll have to make your own conclusions. It's just my two cents. Again, it's versatile. A lot of studio cats play Bachs and they don't switch. Some people have a classical horn, jazz horn, and a Bach, like a Yamaha, is versatile, can do it all. The quality of these horns, for the most part, is a given. And at the end of the day, when you're satisfied with all these horns, and you're wondering which one you want to buy, it comes down to which one you want to see in your case every day. Are you a Bach fan? Are you a Yamaha fan? Maybe a Thomann fan? Some horn has your name on it, you just gotta find it. They all sound a little bit different, but I think every person has an idea in their head of what a trumpet is supposed to sound like. So yeah, it's not bad, but, and you can't put your finger on it, and then you'll pick up horn and say, yeah, that's what a horn is supposed to sound like. Maybe that's the horn for you. Now we're gonna cheat a little bit, because we're Thomann. And we're gonna have two Thomann horns. Saw that one coming though, didn't you? This is the 5000 series, and this one has a red brass bell. Maybe it's not obvious, but it does have a slightly higher copper content than a standard brass bell. The reason we're having two Thomann horns is not because we're Thomann and we want to push our own products, is because this horn and the horn we're going to get to in a minute don't really fit in this price class. That's my opinion. Probably people in the store will disagree with me, but in my opinion, this horn belongs in a higher price class. It's listed kind of as an intermediate beginner-ish horn, but I would do a gig with it. There's a lot of similarities. It has adjustable fingering, but instead of a saddle for the thumb, it has a complete circle, just a little classier. You'll notice here on the front, the main tuning slide isn't D-shaped. It's reverse construction, and this is completely round. That gives you less resistance, a more even blow. The main brace is a little bit further back. It's going to give you to the player, it's going to give you more feedback. If it were more forward, it might project better, but it would have a completely different sound characteristic. Slides are wonderful. There's good vacuum there. Valves just click. And it's also, more importantly, fun to play. Not just for jazz. These come in all kinds of different flavors. It has this, the gold brass bell, it has just a regular brass bell. You get a silver plated, silver with gold accents, you can get a black nickel one, an antique finish. Not just for jazz, but I like jazz. I'm American, come on. This is the Thomann TR-200. This is 149 euros. We're talking really base entry, student level trumpet, but it's just well built and it works. There's nothing special about the horn. It's the components are simple, but they're very consistent. If I have 20 of these on the bench, I got 20 twins, 20 tuplets. You have to Google that. I don't know the right word. Anyway, yeah, what can I say about it? Let me just play maybe something that I played on one of the other horns. It does have a little bit more resistance. I mean, you're not going to get the same horn for 149 that you're going to get for, what, 500, 550, that general neighborhood. But I'll tell you what, if my son learns how to play horn one day, or if he wants to learn how to play trumpet, I'm buying him one of these. I don't know if he's going to stick with it. So it wouldn't be 149 down the drain. So to close out here, I'm going to do just a little comparison. All five of them. Play a little ditty on all of them so you can have a 1-to-1-to-1-to-1-to-1, 1-to-5, a good comparison. Believe it or not, horn and mouthpiece, 249 euros. But you know what? The horns don't play themselves. You gotta go practice. See you next time, YouTube.